How can you look for an approximate match in Excel's IF function? Can you use wildcards in the logical test? That's the topic of today's video. This video is actually inspired by Barrett's comment and question about wildcards. He said he has no problem using wildcards in the SUMIFS formula, but wildcards don't work in the IF formula. Why, and what's the alternative? If you're curious about using wildcards in SUMIFS, I have a separate video on that. Check out the link below. Right here, I have a list of company codes, and what I want to do is write a formula that types AT in this column if it finds it in the code here. And it doesn't matter where it finds it. So it can be at the beginning, the end, or in the middle. It should put in AT here. And if it doesn't find it, it should put nothing. Let's just start off with our IF formula. First argument is the logical test. And if I just deal with this the way I would use wildcards in the SUMIFS formula, and I type in equals the asterisk sign, which represents any text, put in the asterisk sign right after that, let's see what happens. So that's our logical test. Next is value if true. So if it's true, I want it to return 80. If not, nothing, right? So quotation, quotation, close bracket. Now it doesn't matter if this is small or capital, but I'll just make it capital to be consistent. Press enter, it doesn't find it. Right, so Excel doesn't like us using wildcards right after the equal sign. All the functions that have this type of logical test don't like to use them in this way. In the SUMIFS formula, we don't type this after the equal sign. We type it right after the argument separator. So if you're dealing with cases like this, like the IF function, you actually have to use an alternate method. And that one is using another function. That function is the search function. So let me show you what search does. The first argument in the search function is the text we want to find. So let's say we type in 18 quotation, or we can reference it to this cell right here. I'm going to press F4 for absolute referencing. Where are we looking this in? I'm looking it in here. Start number is an optional argument, is which character do you want it to start reading? So number one would be the first character. Number two is from the second character. And default is to start reading from the beginning. That's what we want. So I'm going to press enter and we get one. One means that AT starts from the first character. If AT wasn't here, so let me just change that to like PT, put AT here, it starts from the fifth character. Notice that it's not case sensitive. So I'm looking for capital AT and I've typed here small letters and it finds it, because the search function is not case sensitive. If you are looking for something and you want it to be that exact case, you need to use the find function instead, right? Because find is case sensitive. So it's not finding this AT in here unless I change it to capital AT and then it finds it. In this case, I'm just going to go with the search function, and let's just put AT here in the front, change that to some other values. That gives me a number. Now, if I was looking for SE and there is no SE there, it gives me an error. This is the information I can use as my wildcard, because the moment I get a number back, it means that this text exists. If I get an error, it means it doesn't exist. And a great formula for that is to use the isNumber function, because isNumber takes a look at that value that the search function returns and checks, is this a number? If it's a number, it returns true. If it's not a number, it returns false. So if I change this to SE, it finds an error, right? It's not a number, so I get false in here. And exactly this information is something I can use as my wildcard. So I'm just going to copy this, go back to my formula, and change the logical test here to my isNumber formula. Because if it's a true, it's going to return 80. If it's a false, it's going to return nothing. Press enter, I get 80 back. So let's pull this down, and I get AT back for these. So even here, when it's in the middle of the code, it still returns it. That's how you can use wildcards in the IF function, and also other similar functions where you do logical tests, like the sum product function. In the second case, we want to take a look at if we have AT or DE in there, we want to return Europe, right? So let's combine this together with the OR logical test. So let's start off with if. Our logical test consists of two things to be tested, and here we can start off with the OR function. The first part is, can we find AT in here? We just need the exact same formula we had before, so I'm just going to paste it in and pull this reference to here, right? So that's one logical test. The next one is the same, let's paste it again, except that we want to look for DE. And I'm going to close the OR function. Next, what do we want return if it's true? Well, we want to see Europe here, otherwise nothing. Close bracket, press enter. Okay, so let's just bring this down, highlight, control enter to copy down without the formatting. So wherever I see DE or AT, I get Europe. For the other ones, I see nothing. Okay, so the ISNUMBER function together with SEARCH or the FIND functions can act as your wildcards inside the IF function. I hope you like this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. And if you want to improve your Excel skills and become a bit more advanced in Excel, consider subscribing to this channel.